What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes, heading on my next service call. We're in Oyster Bay, north shore of Long Island in Nassau County. We got a Hayward pool heater, heat pump, ain't working. Let's go check it out. We're right around the corner. I've been driving for almost an hour to get to this service call. Let's go give them a once over, take care of them, get him up and running. That's the goal.
Let's go see what's going on here.
I do have to compliment you on your channel.
Thank you.
Comical, bro.
I love it. Thank you. Appreciate it. Really appreciate it. I guess it's probably one of the reasons why I'm here now.
Yeah. So I don't know if your assistant mentioned it to you. Okay, I live
your
in
friend. Your friend. This is your friend's house. He has a pool heater. You want his pool heater, but it doesn't work.
There you go.
Okay.
And I know you don't service Hampton Bay.
Not yet. So maybe in a couple years.
Let me just put that.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we got this Hayward Heat Pro heat pump pool heater. She's looking pretty nice. 410A system, 5 pounds, 3 ounces, that's all it needs. Someone had a little fun with spray paint here. I'm gonna take this as the electric outlet inlet. And he's got a pool house with all the equipment in there.
I was thinking of doing the same. It's just a shame to take the space away from my pool house.
I know,
just
I hear you.
I know.
But he had, what's going on? He had some kind of gas heater in there. Yeah, he had a gas heater in there at one point. For sure. All right, we're going to see what's wrong with this bad boy.
I follow electricians before, you know, the guy used to work also for a pool company. So he was checking in here. Maybe he unplugged or something. I don't know. Everything is plugged in.
I just took the cover off.
I don't know. Why it doesn't show HI.
All right. Either a water leak or water got in here. Contactors are all corroded and rusted. Wiring is disconnected. And the fuse is missing as well. The fuse is missing. This wire's all frayed. Okay. So give me some history with this.
So I know you had an HI error, high pressure.
Yeah.
So when's the last time someone's been inside here? What were they doing? Who was it?
He was checking this. I don't know why. He was checking this.
Okay.
He said to me, this looks like it's not that good, this one.
It looks like it's not that good.
Not good. He said,
okay, what else did he say?
Change it. And he told me the same thing. Maybe it wasn't the water leaking or something.
Yeah. You want to turn the pool pump on and we'll see if this thing's leaking any water?
Yeah.
And let's do a... Let's do a quick little test here and see if we have any refrigerant in the system. Let's see. No. Wow. So the homeowner is saying how the control board doesn't look good. I think that's probably one of the best things that'll look right here. Nice and clean. Corrosion present. It looks okay. So we have a jumper across 3 and 4, which is frayed. The fuse is missing. We have tons of corrosion and rust behind the transformer, and then going to our compressor capacitor and fan capacitor. Inside here, yes, someone has been repairing this thing in the past. All right. Let's take our little popper and let's see what happens. Really? Immediately going to high pressure fault. We hooked up our probes to the high and low side, and we have even pressure of 170 psi, so we don't have high pressure. We may have to jump out our pressure switch, which is on 5 and 6. See what's going on with that. Keep in mind that this is not connected. So that was probably on that contactor, 24 volt coil.
Oh, it's HI now.
Well, yeah, because I'm I'm bypassing things to get it to do something.
So you try to put on without IC.
Okay, so now it's still showing high, and our high pressure sensor is off, and you have a bad board.
Of the unit.
The compressor is like the engine of the system.
Got it.
Okay. All right, we're gonna start the fan and see if that turns on, and see what happens. I'm just gonna push in the contactor. All right, it's a good thing. Yeah, there's definitely water was leaking in here. I don't know where it came from or where it originated, should I say. But you definitely had a leak here because of the amount of rust that is
that you can
right
see.
Right behind that transformer. And When you have an appliance like this that has water passing through it as its normal course of operation, you know, it makes you think of where did this come from? So now, coupled with the fact that there's a piece of pipe insulation on this unit that is not factory, it's probably had a leak on it, and it was repaired, just based on what I see. Why else would there be a non-factory piece of insulation on the system?
And that
could have been the normal course of operation. The homeowner may have never even known, you know? And maybe the pool company came here, saw it was leaking, made a repair. I have no idea.
Now, in order to access the internal pipes of the unit, the whole top fan unit piece has to come off in order to access the piping that's inside?
Yeah, this has to come apart.
To determine if it's leaking inside?
Well, you'd see it, but yeah.
Okay.
So it's not because I didn't put the cover in the beginning?
No.
I think so, right?
No, I don't think so. Because they're designed to be outdoors. You know?
I mean, like, winterize it.
Yeah. So even looking at this contact, yeah, I wouldn't.
So there is that contactor, fully rusted and with corrosion on the contact points. I guess we can start and see what happens.
All right, I'll just look the other way in case, God forbid, something happens here. Yeah, and my pressures, you know, didn't move around, so it's compressing to an extent. So you may get lucky if you throw some parts at this, like the contact. I would replace all the electrics, the two contactors, the two capacitors, that control board, and then hope for the best at that point. You know, if it's really 3 years old, you should get another 7 years out of this. You know, the biggest demise with these systems is refrigerant leaks. Just like a central air conditioning system, you know, you have a hermetically sealed system.
Can I just stop you there? Is that the leak that caused the rust?
No.
Okay,
no.
You're talking about a different kind of
leak. This is a refrigerant leak. This is a...
Got it. Referring it to a refrigerator or yeah. Like a car.
Yeah,
Losing Freon.
Correct.
Got it.
So like in a home residential system, you have an outdoor unit, you have an indoor unit, you have pipes that connect the two systems together.
Yes.
This is a self-contained system. Like, you know, you see some on commercial buildings, you have a package unit which everything is there, and with ductwork, right? So here, everything...
Like a window air conditioner. It's all in one.
Exactly. So the biggest demise with these are refrigerant leaks. Because A, you have an older system with older refrigerant that's phased out, right? So if this developed a refrigerant leak, minimum $1,000, $1,500, just minimum, just to get started.
In order to get to that point, to determine if it has a refrigerant leak, we have to go through the mother. We have to go forward.
I'm just giving you like the what typically goes wrong with these. With
oh,
these systems.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is there a way to test? Is there if there's a refrigerant leak?
You have refrigerant in the system, so there's it appears to be okay. Okay. But we're not going to know until the system's fully up and running. Okay. And we could duplicate that. I could force the fan on. I could force the compressor on, and we can watch it. You know, you want to spend some more time here? We could do that. It's fine.
I think it's better because you don't
want to
waste.
Yeah, and then we could see
what
the temperature is coming out of the pool is. So with heat pumps for pools, you usually get around 3 to 4 degrees.
Every hour?
No, 4 degrees coming out of the supply. You know those jets. So we could force this on, and we could see what it does.
Okay, so what you're saying is that these heat pumps only make a difference of 3 to 4 degrees with your water temperature.
No, I'm giving you too much information.
No,
and you're,
it's fine.
And
you're,
no, because you're misinterpreting it, right? When the system's running,
yes.
The pool temperature, let's say the pool temperature is 80 degrees.
Yes.
The air coming, the water coming out of the vent, out of the jets, around 83, 84 degrees.
I understand.
Okay.
Okay.
If you like, I could force the system to run. Again, at this point, you know, it is what it is. You know, you need parts. And like if it runs and it properly heats, then it may be worthwhile to dump, you know, a significant amount of money into it to make it work.
Well, at first we have to dump the money in the parts. So you would start with that board first, or go right to the board, the transformers, and the cylinder underneath.
I would. At a minimum, you need a board right now.
The board in order to go forward.
Yes.
Okay. What is the cost of the board?
I have to look it up and call the manufacturer.
All right. Is the boards common that they fail?
It's electrical component, power surges, brownouts, you know, it's electrical. So it's if there's not a surge protector in the line, it's something to be considered moving forward.
Okay. All right.
Would you like me to just manually start this and see if it heats?
Yes, please.
Okay.
Now that board is not something you have in stock. You'd have to
Order that from the manufacturer.
Okay.
This is an older model. And to stock parts, you know, it'd be obscene to do that here.
What was it called? Motherboard, you said?
Control board.
Control board. For Hayward.
Come on, baby.
Control board. For Hayward.
So as far out as Suffolk County you go, Mike?
Usually Deer Park Avenue, but we don't typically service.
I think it's approximately between $400 or $500, something like that.
Yeah, in that range probably. Yeah, that's not the right control board.
I know. But it's approximately.
Approximately, yeah.
Can I look down the camera?
Yeah, sure. I'm about to turn it on, though.
Okay.
All right. So, I forced the compressor, and I forced the condenser fan motor both to run. We have... almost 4 PSI and 264. And the air coming out of here should be much cooler than ambient. We'll take some readings. All right, ambient of 62. Fifty-one degrees. All right, pool temperature. Sixty-nine and a half. Let's get that thermocouple in there. Yeah, so about 3 degrees. Okay. All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching this video on this Hayward Heat Pro pool heater. Obviously been neglected, someone not knowing what they're doing, but nonetheless, we left no stone unturned. We tested everything with this system. We tested the compressor. We tested the condenser fan motor. We documented the condition of the system, and we made our recommendations, which is that control board, transformer, condenser fan motor capacitor, condenser fan motor contactor, compressor capacitor, and compressor fan, and compressor contactor, at a minimum, to put this system in a dependable and reliable state, noting the visible damage to said components warrants the need to replace our recommendation. Some of you may not agree, but it is what it is. If you want to have a reliable heater that's working to heat your pool, you're going to need to pay the piper. And if you live in the Long Island, New York City metropolitan area and you're tired of getting bamboozled by your HVAC contractor to work on your pool heater, or your equipment in your home or office, I want you to pick up the phone and give me a call, 516-348-6300. Or save time, book online at pipedoc.net. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, be well, God bless, stay safe. Now I gotta drive an hour to get back to our neck of the woods. Look at this, it's like we're in the country here. Whip it, wanna do some whippets? Love you guys. Be well.